Oh, he's getting a clear charge in, because if you notice, our opponent just put down big resources on the right side of the screen. Hello everybody, Graysteel Plays, and we're back with more Clash Royale. Oh, I'm having so much fun with this game. Today I want to show you some footage of me fighting in Arena 3. Well, I say footage, but we're just going to go ahead and fight in Arena 3 in a little bit here. Let's go ahead and open these various chests first and see what we got. I'm expecting a bunch of common cards. Oh, a giant in a free chest. Yes, that's so delicious. Oh, we have another free chest. Let's open this baby and get some more gold. Give me another giant. Oh, I haven't unlocked that yet. That's the Barbarian's card. It's like a little grouping card where it sends out multiple creatures at once. All right, so let's go ahead and open the silver chest here. Some gold, some spear goblins, who I woefully do not use at all, and a goblin hut. And how about this gold chest? Let's get some good stuff. Come on, no whammies. 99 gold. I got 99 problems, but gold ain't one of them. Some spear goblins, some archers, and some skeletons. Come on. Yes, and goblin huts. Yes, we're going to be able to level that up. I actually want to get to use the goblin hut again and try a technique today called the swarm technique. That is not what I wanted to click at all. I don't know why I just did that. Let's go down to the deck area right here. Okay, so today I just want to talk quickly about deck construction, but first let's upgrade this, because if I don't do it, I'm going to forget. Now, deck construction in Clash of Clans is something that you have to remember, that Clash of Clans at its base is a strategy game. Essentially, what you're trying to do is be more efficient than your opponent with whatever you put down. That said, there are certain key elements that most decks should have. I say most because a versatile deck is probably a lot better than a niche deck. You're going to want some high hit point level troops like this giant. What is a high hit point level troop? I would say any troop over 1,000 hit points. So for that, in this deck, I have a giant and I have a prince. Now, there's a couple other troops that could go here. I know there is we're talking low level like we are right now, not like golems and stuff way later in the game. I think that there's like a giant skeleton that can go there. Something else that you're going to want to look into is how to deal damage to aerial creatures. Now, this is kind of rarer. Now, if you notice, the Musketeer here can target air and ground, and that's why I love her and why I keep her in my deck. She doesn't have a ton of hit points, she doesn't do a ton of damage, but she can target land and air. But the other thing that can do it is this goblin hut. So for me, it's going to serve dual purposes. It's going to create a steady stream of goblins. These ones, actually. Let's take a look at them real quick. No, there we go. These goblins right here is what it will be creating. You can see that they also attack air and ground. They don't have a lot of hit points. They don't have a lot of damage, but they do damage to aerial creatures, and that's mainly what we want. And their range is not bad. Their speed is pretty good, and basically they're just all around decent damagers to aerial stuff. Something else that you're going to want is area of effect spells. I would say at least one, most likely, or at least a way to do area effect damage to both land and air creatures. For that, I have these arrows. Now take a look for a minute of the radius, which is 4. We're going to need to know that for a moment. Now you'll notice it doesn't do a lot of damage, but that's because all I use it for is taking out minions and skeletal hordes. Let's take a look at this fireball though. Now this fireball, the radius is much less at 2.5, but look at the damage. It's basically like 2x damage, and that'll allow it to take out things like musketeers and stuff, as well as other little creatures. Now what I'm showing you here is just my elixir area, if you notice to the upper part of the screen. 4.1 is where I'm at. I would suggest most of the time, especially in this current level, to range between 3.7 and, I don't know, 4.3. Right around there, you'll be good. Anything lower and you won't have enough power cards to bust through. Anything higher and you won't be able to get down stuff quick enough. Taking a look at the Valkyrie real quick, I wanted to click on her real fast and show you guys this. She is a higher hit point character, not over 1,000, but a decent hit point character, but she does target a group of enemies, but only ground. Now these minions are kind of a cool card. They also target air and ground, and they are themselves an air troop. That kind of makes them pretty special in my eyes, actually. So they're difficult to target by the enemy, and they can do decent damage to both air and ground creatures, but we don't have room for it in this deck. This is the deck I'm going to go with today. This is a swarm deck. Basically, it has ways to make as many troops as possible. The only thing that I would change is probably taking out this prince for a witch, if I had one. Since I don't know, that strapping man is staying in. Skeleton army is kind of integral for this. If you didn't have skeleton army, you could probably get a, you could probably get by with a witch, or something, maybe like that baby dragon there, which I still haven't gotten. Let's take a look at this bomb tower real quick, because I don't have one yet. So the bomb tower has 900 hit points. That's not bad. Its range is pretty good at 6.5, and it does target only ground creatures, but it does target an area, which is nice. 40 gold. I don't think I'm going to buy that yet. Let's take a look at the dragon, though. This dragon is an epic card, but look at that. 800 hit points, 100 area damage. The damage per second isn't fantastic, but it targets air and ground, and it does do area effect damage, which is big in my eyes, and it's an aerial creature, and it has a lot of hit points. So, let's go ahead and go do a battle, a live battle here, and see how this deck does against... it's not really made for level 3 opponents, but what the hell, let's do it anyway! Oh yeah. This deck is more really made for Arena 2. Arena 3, we haven't unlocked a ton of cards yet, so I'm not sure how it's going to perform. Alright, with this setup here... I don't feel like being reactionary. Let's actually go straight in with a prince. I feel like if we can get that in there, and we can probably take down a tower real fast. Oh, he's getting a clear charge in, because if you notice, our opponent just put down big resources on the right side of the screen. That is a giant and a witch. The only problem is that giant and witch are going to do a ton of damage, but our prince is beating the living crap out of that tower. Okay, we just got lost a tower now as well. This is tough, but we have their crown tower, their main... King Tower down to 490 hit points. Let's get a P.E.K.K.A. over here and get rid of these damn troops. We've got to take down that giant, and we've got to take down this stupid witch. Alright, good. We managed to do it. That Valkyrie's slowly closing in, but our constant stream of skeletons is actually creating a big distraction. Let's put this Musketeer down. She's going to fire at the Valkyrie. I put her up ahead so that she can more quickly go up the road line there toward the king. Let's see if I can get some skeletons in. I think this is... Oh, man, he put down a dragon right when I put down those skeletons. I was hoping to get rid of that bomber tower. Let's go ahead and put down a tombstone. We're going to try and get a couple of skeletons out to slow down that dragon. That dragon is going to be a real problem if I don't slow that thing down. Let's see. We only have arrows right now. I don't really want to use that. Let's go ahead and put down a prince. Let's see if we can take down their tombstone and get the... dragon. Nope, he's not going to go for the prince. Alright, that's fine. Let's go ahead and throw these arrows down, finish that off, get a little damage on the Valkyrie. Maybe we can get a good charge in on the... He's got to throw something in or we're going to get it. Okay, he managed to throw in a witch. That is the worst possible scenario for me. The witch is easily going to take out a single damage creature like the prince. Let's go ahead and throw in a P.E.K.K.A. real quick because I don't have anything here that I want to put down. Let's put down a skeleton army. I think the skeleton army might be able to overwhelm the witch. No. Her area effect spell is so powerful, it leveled our skeleton army almost immediately. That was a bad play by me. Let's go ahead and put a tombstone down to distract the different creatures coming out of that area. Okay, our prince is going to take out the giant pretty fast. Some arrows there. I had to get those in real quick. Take down a couple of goblins that had managed to get their way down. I'm going to throw in a P.E.K.K.A. over here, see if I can sneak this P.E.K.K.A. in. They get some damage out. I'm going to wait until that bomb tower fires and put down the skeleton army. There we go. Man, it didn't even get down that Valkyrie. That was a bad combination. The Valkyrie and the bomb tower managed to take us out real fast. Okay, our musketeer is going to do excellent work against the goblin tower. I think that she'll also probably take out the bomb tower. Let's go ahead and put down a prince. He has put down tons of resources on our right side. I think we're going to get an easy charge with the prince, and yes, we got it. Man. That is a big part of the strategy of playing this game, is watching when your opponent... Oh, don't cry. You put out a great fight. Is watching when your opponent puts down his resources. If you can see when they put down a huge amount of resources, you pretty much know when you're going to have an opening or a couple of seconds to get a fighter up and take down that king tower. And that was exactly what I was waiting for. When I saw that giant and the witch go down, I knew it was time to put down a prince, a fast moving creature with a ton of damage. Anyway, guys, hope you enjoyed it. Stay foxy. Much love.